Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, we come together once again to celebrate this fifth Sunday of Easter. And also, we have a second reason. Today is Mother's Day. Blessings to all the mothers of our community. Blessings to all the mothers around the world. Those who are alive and those who are in heaven, may they rest in peace. We are the living stones of God's spiritual house, and Jesus is the cornerstone. Let us be humble as we remember our sins.
Lord Jesus, you are our brother and our guide. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the way and the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are life and hope. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and lead us to an everlasting life.
Amen.
And together we say, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, Only Begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayers. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, constantly accomplish the Paschal mystery within us, that those you were pleased to make new in holy baptism may, under your protective care, bear much fruit and come to the joys of eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. As the number of disciples continued to grow, the Hellenists complained against the Hebrews because their widows were being neglected in the daily distribution. So the 12 called together the community of disciples and said, "It is not right for us to neglect the word of God to serve at table. Brothers, select from among you 7 reputable men, filled with the Spirit and wisdom, whom we shall appoint to this task. Whereas we shall devote ourselves to prayer and to the ministry of the word." The proposal was acceptable to the whole community, so they chose Stephen, a man filled with faith and the Holy Spirit, also Philip, Prochorus, Nicanor, Timon, Parnabas, and Nicholas of Antioch, a convert to Judaism. They presented these men to the apostles, who prayed and laid hands on them. The word of God continued to spread, and the number of disciples in Jerusalem increased greatly. Even a large group of priests were becoming obedient to the faith. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm. Lord, let your mercy be on us as we place our trust in you.
Lord, let your mercy be on us as we place our trust in you.
Exalt you just in the Lord. Praise from the upright is fitting. Give thanks to the Lord on the harp. With the 10-string lyre, chant his praises.
Lord, let your mercy be on us as we place our trust in you.
Upright is the word of the Lord, and all his works are trustworthy. He loves justice and right. Of the kindness of the Lord, the earth is full.
Lord, let your mercy be on us as we place our trust in you.
See, the eyes of the Lord are upon those who fear him, upon those who hope for his kindness, to deliver them from death and preserve them in spite of famine.
Lord, let your mercy be on us as we place our trust in you.
A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, come to him, a living stone, rejected by human beings, but chosen and precious in the sight of God. And like living stones, let yourselves be built into a spiritual house, to be holy priesthood, to offer spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For it is said in Scripture, Behold, I am laying a stone in Zion, a cornerstone, chosen and precious. And whoever believes in it shall not be put to shame. Therefore, its value is for you who have faith. But for those without faith, the stone that the builder rejected has become the cornerstone, a stone that will make people stumble and a rock that will make them fall. They stumble by disobeying the word, as is their destiny. You are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people of his own, so that you may announce the praises of him who called you out of darkness into a wonderful light. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I'm going, you know the way. Thomas said to him, Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, then you will also know my Father. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. Philip said to him, Master, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us. Jesus said to him, Have I been with you for so long a time, and you still do not know me, Philip? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, Show us the Father? Do you not believe that I am the Father, and the Father is in me? The words that I speak to you, I do not speak on my own. The Father who dwells in me is doing his work. Believe in me. Believe me that I am the Father, and the Father is in me. Or else believe because of the works themselves. Amen, amen, I say to you. Whoever believes in me will do the works that I do, and will do greater ones than these, because I am going to the Father. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, some dwellings are built out of stones. Mansions, houses, residences, dwellings are made of diverse materials. Here in the United States, for the most part, we built them out of wood, stone, brick, and in the case of the very poor, even out of cardboard or plastic tents. In the area where Jesus lived, the dwellings were either a tent if you lived in the desert, or if you lived in a city or a town, they were made out of stone. Only the best stones were used for such task. And these stone houses, regardless of their size, were built solid and exuded a sense of stability and natural beauty and gravitas. These are qualities evoked by the image of the dwellings that Jesus will prepare for us. As Christians, we view our life journey as a pilgrimage to home, with its twists and turns, its rough passages, its surprises, joys, and challenges. Jesus provides us an access to the heavenly kingdom through the vehicle of faith. We are called to a reality free of anxieties, full of consolation, and lacking of nothing. And for us Christians, Jesus is the way. Faith in Jesus will enable us to face the challenges of life and to realize that no matter how overwhelmed we may be by life trials, it's not the end. It is faith in our holding on to the promises of Jesus what shall see us through. Let not your hearts be troubled, says the gospel. Do not be afraid, says the song. Our faith will take us to our true and real and final destination in what it is known as our gift given by Jesus to rise. He is the way, the truth, and the life. And as Christians, we are travelers of that path. We are the recipients of that truth. And we are the children of that eternal life. But while Jesus prepares our dwellings at the heavenly banquet, we are to build our own temporary dwelling here on earth. And sometimes the stones used for such will be rejected. How many of us have experienced rejection just because we believe in Christ, just because we are Catholics, just because we have faith? It has happened to most people, rejection. This was not only true for our brothers and sisters who fight racism, or women who fight discrimination, or people who are from other countries and fight all kinds of discrimination as well. But you see, it happened to our angular stone. It happened to Jesus. He was discarded by a group who didn't understand his good news and consider him no good. But rejection has no place in our life. Rejection has no place in our existence as a Christian Catholic. It can't be part of our present and has no place in our future. The kingdom of God is for all those who follow God's designs and God's will. Heaven is not a club. Heaven is not an exclusive, reality. To close its doors as if there is such thing as a Catholic heaven alone to other realities is a mistake. I have seen many Muslims, Jews, Buddhists, Gnostics, and even some atheists whose concern and love and charity towards others puts many of us Christians to shame. They may not perceive God within the same lines of understanding like us, but in their actions, many of them follow God's desire for humanity and are indirect contributors of Jesus' plan of salvation. So why reject other realities when it's God's job and duty and right to decide what to do with them and who gets saved? We open ourselves to inclusivity and a call to save others, to save ourselves, to save all. Let us follow the example, certainly of Jesus, but also the example of his mother, the Blessed Virgin Mary, whom we honor today as we have her image here present, crowned. There's another example, mothers. Mothers that forgive it all. Mothers that understand it all. Mothers that want the best for their children. And they know how to love until it hurts. Today, on Mother's Day, I wish to send a message to all our mothers here in the parish. A message of love, a message of respect, a message of honor, a message of faith. Thank you for your ministry in your motherhood. Not only those that have brought life physically, but also mothers spiritually. Women that with their job, their ministry, their lifestyle, they give life to others. Dear brothers and sisters, let us open ourselves to inclusivity and a call to save others. Without limiting this call to a physical condition, to a religious denomination, or any kind of difference. Only in such we shall know the way. Only in such we shall build with living stones, like the ones keeping the faith in the Holy Land, in our country, in our Church of St. Aloysius. By building such dwellings here on earth, we shall be looking with confidence and hope to our future dwelling. Some dwellings are made of stone. The eternal ones are made of faith. Amen. Brothers and sisters, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Dearly beloved, the first Christians bore witness to Christ by serving the community of faith. Let us participate with them as we serve one another.
Please let us respond, Christ hear us.
Christ hear us.
Let's pray for those baptized this year and all for all the baptized in the world, that Christ's risen glory be our constant inspiration and joy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Christ hear us.
Let us pray for the leaders and citizens of all nations, that our commitment to peace and justice inspire others. Let us pray to the Lord.
Christ hear us.
For the young people, especially those most in need, that they find true support in those who love them and accept God's call to a full and happy life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Christ hear us.
And for all the sick in our families and in our communities, let us pray to the Lord.
Christ hear us.
And for all those who have died, we pray that they rejoice in the heavenly banquet. Let us pray to the Lord.
Christ hear us. Let us remember the intentions of this Mass. We so pray for the repose of Maria Cassiana Ries, the repose of Maria de la Rosa, the repose of Carmen de la Rosa, and also for the repose of Father Anthony Tallarico, who was a priest here and served this community for many years. May they rest in peace. We pray to the Lord.
Christ hear us.
We also pray for our mothers, those who are alive and those who are in heaven. May the Lord always protect them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Christ hear us.
God of love and mercy, we give you thanks for the gift of faith. Listen to the petitions we present to you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of his holy church.
O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead. Grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. So that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit. Graciously, make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you.
My Lord and my God.
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
My Lord
and my God.
And ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her husband, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, Saint Agnes, St. Fidelis, St. Aloysius Gonzaga, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession, in your presence, we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth. With your servant, Francis, our Pope, and Blaise, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this time, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestowed on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always,
and with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
At this moment, I invite all of you to do a spiritual communion.
Thank you.
to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you for your continued and generous support of our parish. If you wish to continue to support our parish during our closure, you can do so by mailing in your offerings. But please, do not send cash to the mail, but register online at giftcentral.org. You can also text Sunday to 773-389-1059. Your donations are greatly appreciated. Please continue to join us every Sunday during this quarantine time for Mass on our Facebook page and also on YouTube at St. Aloysius Knights of Columbus. We also ask you to please check into our Facebook page and also our webpage for the most recent announcements regarding our closures and or changes to our schedule. Have a blessed Mother's Day.
And of course, at this point, I wish to honor and remember our spiritual mother, the Virgin Mary, who was here with us in her image through all this Eucharistic celebration. And to her, with our hearts, we say,
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
And of course, brothers and sisters, don't give up. Don't give up. Never give up. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mass is ended. Let us go in peace. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia.